the hostel. They were kind enough to grant us hostel rooms in Narmada. And most of the door numbers were washed away because they're getting painted. But then the surprise came in when we noticed roll number of one of the first rooms that we saw. We are all from the class of 2008, so our roll numbers were ME04, blah, blah, blah. And the first number we saw was ME12, ME12. So that's 8 years ahead of us. And there's like, you know, you're growing old or what's happening? It's like complete shocker. So, yeah, okay. So, yeah, but I think it was a fantastic experience to come back. I think from our batch, we are quite young to actually talk about our feats, etc. So we thank all the stalwarts over here because it's because of the traditions that you guys have set, which we followed, fortunately, and we are what we are. So thank you to all the batches before us. A few aha moments from last few years which I've spent away from home, which keep reminding me what IIT truly is. I mean, this morning, listening to Professor Jhunjhunwala just reminded me that you don't need to attend a TED conference to feel wowed. You just need to come back to IIT Madras. So every time you're here, you just feel wowed. And I remember one incident which happened about 3 months ago. I'm currently working in Sarawak, Borneo. I went to a local tribesman's place. So they live in a longhouse with 50, 60 homes, and all families are staying next to one another. So it's pretty remote in forests, and they don't really have access to great education, so to say. So one of my close colleagues is from that place. So I go there, and I interact with some of the children. And one kid who's about 14 years old, he comes to me and says, and bear in mind that these are people who do not really have great access to education. He comes to me and says, I wish I could go to IIT. And I hadn't said a word that I am from IIT. I hadn't said a word about anything about India, but he said that I wish I could go to Indian Institute of Technology. So that just showed us what we stand for. Yeah. So thanks to one and all. Thank you for having us here.
I just wanted to lay to rest one misconception that seems to be there. Our alumni FS secretary, president seemed to point out that nobody does core jobs anymore. He's in a core job, I'm in a core job, he's in a core job, he's in a core job, he's in a core job. So that's 5 out of 6. They're all engineers. So that's all. Thanks, guys.